sagutan natin itong problem. Solve the following quadratic equation. So let's start with 1. X squared minus 9 is equal to 0. So meron tayong general form ng quadratic equation na ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So dito sa given natin, meron tayong ax squared term which corresponds ito sa x squared. Tapos itong constancy natin, meron tayo which is negative 9. So meron tayong missing term na bx or yung x term. So kapag ganun yung case, missing yung bx, ang gagawin nyo lang is i-isolate nyo lang yung x squared doon sa constant. So pwede kong i-add 9 both sides of the equation. So magiging x squared, negative 9 plus 9 cancel. Magiging sa right side is 0 plus 9, positive 9. Tapos kukuhaan nyo lang yung square root ng both sides para makancel yung exponent ni x na 2. So square root ng x squared, that's x. And then, kuhaan nyo lang yung square root ng 9. So tatandaan nyo, lalagyan nyo ng plus minus yung square root nitong constant. So magiging plus minus square root ng 9 is 3. Right? Because 3 square is equal to 9. So therefore, ang solution natin is x is equal to plus minus 3. So we have two roots sa quadratic equations. So it can be x is equal to positive 3 or x is equal to negative 3. Next, we have x squared equal to 2x. So again, sa ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So meron tayong ax squared term which is x squared. Then meron tayong bx term which is itong 2x. So wala ngayon tayong constant, okay? So kapag wala tayong constant, so equate nyo muna sa 0. So ibig sabihin, ma-minus ko 2x both sides, okay? So magiging x squared minus 2x itong left. And then 2x minus 2x sa right, so magiging 0 na. So ang gagawin na lang natin dito is factoring, common monomial factoring to solve for the roots. Okay, so factoring out, common monomial factor ng x squared minus 2x, that's x lang, right? Okay, factoring out x, itong x squared magiging x squared divided by x, that's x. Then negative 2x divided by x minus 2, right? Equal 0. Then equate lang natin each factor to 0. So itong x equate nyo sa 0. And then itong x minus 2 na factor equate nyo rin sa 0. So ito na yung isang root natin, x is equal to 0. And then solve na lang natin itong isang equation, x minus 2 is equal to 0 for x. So add 2 both sides. So magiging x is equal to, so cancel the 2, equal to 0 plus 2, that's 2. So meron tayong dalawang solutions for x, x is 0 and x is equal to 2. Next for number 3, we have x squared plus 5 is equal to 7. So again, wala rin tayong x term dito. So ang gagawin ko lang is i-isolate ko yung x squared sa constant. So i-minus ko both sides ng 5. Okay, we have x squared. Then 5 minus 5 cancel 0. Magiging 7 minus 5 sa right, that's 2. Okay? Then, tsaka natin i-square root both sides. So square root tong x squared, x na lang. Then, therefore, the value of x is plus minus square root ng 2. Or x is equal to positive square root ng 2 and x is equal to negative square root of 2. Next, for number 4, we have 5x squared plus 5x is equal to x squared plus 2x. Okay, kung mapapansin natin, wala pa rin tayong constant dito. So, meron tayong quadratic equation na missing yung constant. So, sige, i-combine na lang natin similar terms, equate to 0. So, magma-minus ako ng x squared to both sides. Okay, para makancel dito sa right si x squared. So, magiging 5x squared minus x squared, 4x squared. Plus, 5x is equal to 2x. Then, para ma-equate sa 0, ima-minus ko both sides ng 2x. Okay, so 2x minus 2x sa right side, 0 na. And then, dito sa left side, we have 4x squared plus 5x minus 2x magiging 3x. Okay, so tsaka natin if a factor, common monomial factoring, common monomial factor is x lang, right? So factoring out x, so magiging 4x squared divided by x, 4x. Plus 3x divided by x, 3. Equal to 0. Then equate natin each factor to 0. So x is equal to 0, and then 4x plus 3 is equal to 0. So minus 3 both sides, so magiging 4x is equal to 0 minus 3, negative 3. Then to solve for x, divide both sides by 4. So therefore, x is equal to negative 3 over 4 or negative 3/4. So we have two solutions, x is 0 and x is negative 3/4. Next, for number 5, we have 4x squared plus x plus 2x plus 3 equal to 3x plus 4. So combine ko muna yung similar terms, 4x squared plus, okay, x plus 2x, that's 3x plus 3 equal to 3x plus 4. Okay, so check natin, i-transform natin into general form, equate natin sa 0. So, cancelin natin tong 3x saka 4 sa right side. So, pwede akong mag-subtract ng 3x saka 4 both sides. Okay, so magiging 4x squared, 3x minus 3x cancel, 0. Then 3 minus 4, negative 1. Equal, so 3x minus 3x cancel, 4 minus 4 cancel, so 0 na yung right side. So nagkaroon tayo ng quadratic equation na merong missing na x term. Kasi meron lang tayong 4x squared tsaka yung constant na negative 1. So sige, ililipat ko na lang itong negative 1 sa right, so mag-a-add ako ng 1 both sides. So magiging 4x squared, then negative 1 plus 1, 0, cancel, then 0 plus 1, positive 1. So, meron pa tayong coefficient ni x squared na 4. I-divide ko muna both sides by 4. So, cancel. We have x squared is equal to 1/4. Then, to solve for x, get the square root of both sides. So, bali, square root ng x squared, x na lang. And what is the square root of 1/4? So, put plus minus, square root of 1/4 is 1/2, right? Since 1/2 squared, it's 1/4. So, therefore, we have two solutions of x is 1/2 and x is negative 1/2. Okay? Okay, now it's your turn. So, tayo namang sagutan itong problems and just comment your answers.